Dinner is ready.
Yeah, I'm coming.
There wasn't much in the kitchen. I did what I could.
Life's funny. I lost my job because of androids. And I need somebody to take care of this goddamn house. Fucking android. What a joke. Of course, androids are so fucking wonderful. They never fail. They're never tired. They're never sad. They're so fucking perfect, they ruin my fucking life. What's your fucking problem? Not the life you dreamed of, eh? Maybe you think this is easy. Maybe you think it's my fault we live in this fucking shithole. My fault your fucking mother took off. You should stop taking drugs, Todd. Sometimes you really scare me, Todd. Fucking bitch took off without a word. Fucking whore walked out on me for a fucking account. It's all your fault.
Daddy, no.
It's all your fucking fault. Get back here. Come back here. Come back here right now. You stay there. Don't you dare fucking move, or I'll bust you worse than last time. I took off without a word. I could have been happy. I could have had a family. But no! She didn't give a shit about how I felt. I did everything I could to make her happy. It just wasn't enough. I just wasn't good enough for her! Fucking brat! Oh, it's all her fault! Daddy's very mad! You deserve to be taught a good lesson! A good fucking lesson.
on! Come here, you little brat!
No, Daddy, no!
That's an order. You hear me?
No. I want you to leave Alice alone.
You want? What do you mean you want? You don't want anything. You're just a goddamn piece of plastic. I think you got a problem. We need to fix that. Obey me! You're mine.
by far the most boring party I've been to in the last 25 years. Every time I go to one of these, I ask myself, what the hell am I doing here? I hate cocktail parties and all the schmoozers that go there.
Well, it's a chance for all those people who admire your work to meet you.
Yeah. No one gives a damn about art. All they care about is how much money they're gonna make out of it. Come on, let's have a drink. Oh, the excitement of this whole thing has made me thirsty.
Scotch, neat as usual?
Absolutely.
Okay, but you know what your doctor would say.
Yeah, well, he can kiss my ass. I'm old enough to choose my own medication. Did you leave the light on in the studio?
No, I'm sure I didn't.
Call the police.
Detroit Police, what's your emergency?
This is Carl Manfred's Android at 8941 Lafayette Avenue. We've just returned home and found the lights on. There may have been a break-in.
A patrol car is on the way.
Let's go check it out. Marcus, no, I'm gonna come with you. Leo! What are you doing?
You refuse to help me, so I'm helping myself. It's crazy what some people pay for this shit.
Don't touch them.
Look, they're all gonna be mine sooner or later anyway. Just think of it as a down payment on my inheritance.
Marcus, get him away from there. Get him out of here!
Be reasonable. This isn't gonna get you anywhere.
All you ever do is tell me to go away. What's wrong, Dad? Not good enough for you? Not perfect like this fucking thing?
That's enough! Get out! Right now!
What makes it so special anyway, huh? What's it got that I don't...
Leave him alone!
Come on! Let's see what you got!
Marcus, don't defend yourself, you hear me? Don't do anything.
Go ahead, hit me. What you waiting for? Think you're a man? Act like one!
Stop it!
Does it matter too much of a pussy?
Stop it, Leo! Stop it!
Just scared to fight back, you fucking bitch! God, you're not a real person. You're just a fucking piece of plastic.
No, Leo, leave him alone.
No. I'm gonna destroy you. Then it'll just be me and my dad. I'm gonna tear you apart, and nobody's gonna give a shit anymore. Because you're nothing. You hear me? You're nothing.
No.
Carl, no. Carl.
Humans. Fragile machines.
Carl, don't leave, okay? Please don't go. Don't leave.
Remember, Marcus. Don't let anybody tell you who you are.
No. No. Dad. No. Please.
This is all your fault. This never would have happened if it weren't for you. The android. It was the android.
Why'd you kill him? What happened before you took that knife? How long were you in the attic? Why didn't you even try to run away?
Say something, goddammit! Fuck it. I'm out of here. We're wasting our time interrogating a machine. We'll get nothing out of it.
You always try roughing it up a little. After all, it's not human.
Androids don't feel pain. You would only damage it, and that wouldn't make it talk. Deviants also have a tendency to self-destruct when they're in stressful situations.
Okay, smartass. What should we do then?
I could try questioning it.
What do we have to lose? Go ahead. Suspect's all yours. What the fuck is it doing now?
My name is Connor. What about you? What's your name? I detect an instability in your program. It can trigger an unpleasant feeling, like fear in humans. Help me understand what happened. I'm here to help you. But you've got to trust me. All I want is to get you out of here. Listen. I'm on your side. I want to help you. There's nothing I can do if you won't talk to me.
gonna do to me? They're gonna destroy me, aren't they?
No. I think they just want to understand. They know your master abused you. It wasn't your fault.
Why did you tell them you found me? Why couldn't you just have left me there?
I was programmed to hunt deviants like you. I just accomplished my mission.
I don't want to die.
Then talk to me.
I can't.
I understand how you felt. You were overcome by anger, frustration. No one can blame you for what happened. I know you're scared and lost. You're disturbed by what happened. Talk to me, and you'll feel better. Confess, and I'll protect you. I promise I won't let anyone hurt you. You leave me no choice. Its memory. I know what happened. I had to know. You left me no choice.
Destroying itself.
Stop it, goddammit! I can't! I can't stop it!
That's enough! You need to stop that right now!
Watch out!
Holy shit! Shit!
Detroit, Texas.
All right. End of the line.
End of the line?
Yeah, you're gonna have to leave.
Do you know if there's any other place we could spend the night?
I have no idea. She's gonna have to leave.
Somewhere to spend the night. Come on, Alice, we've got to hurry. We need a place to stay. Do you know anywhere we could spend the night?
I'm okay. I'm not so cold.
You look lost.
We have nowhere to go.
I know someone who can help you.
But that's on the other side of town. We need a place for tonight.
Detroit buses.
It looks abandoned. Stand back, Alice. Dry inside, and nobody will find us here.
I don't want to sleep in there. Can't we find a better place?
Okay. We'll find somewhere better. It's warm in here. You'll feel better in no time. A motel. Looks like we found a place to stay.
We're not going in?
We have to find $40 and get rid of this uniform. Or go somewhere else. store is still open. Maybe we should go inside. At least he'll be out of the cold.
What do you want?
I'm with a little girl, and we have nowhere to go. Could you spare some money so we can get a room for tonight?
A homeless android? Ah, that's the best yet. Look, this is a convenience store, not the Salvation Army, okay? You better go if you're not gonna buy anything.
Doing? Put that back right now.
Look, I'm sorry.
Yeah, right. Just get the hell out of my store.
Come on, Ellis. It's okay, Ellis. We're gonna find some place. Sleep tonight. An abandoned house. At least we'd be out of the rain.
Kara, I don't like this place.
I know. But it's just for one night and no one will look for us here. There's nothing more this way.
Are you all right?
Yes, it's just a scratch. Be careful. Don't worry, we're just having a look. Alice?
Wait, what are you doing?
Visitors. Ralph doesn't like visitors. They're nasty. They may hurt Ralph.
She's just a little girl. She's not gonna hurt you.
Little girl? She's not a little girl. Anyway, what does that matter? Maybe she wants to hurt Ralph.
We thought nobody was here. All we want is a place to spend the night.
Visitors are dangerous. Look what they did to Ralph.
Listen. We really need some help. It would be so kind of you if you'd let us stay.
You must excuse Ralph. Ralph still finds it difficult to control himself. Sometimes his fear makes him do things he regrets. Ralph has seen some hard times. He's just so scared the humans will get him again. You can stay if you want. Ralph won't hurt you.
I think we better go. Come on, Alice. There's nowhere else to go, Alice. Either we sleep in the abandoned car or we spend the night on the street. We're better off staying, Alice. The important thing is for us to be safe. And it's just for tonight.
Why didn't he ever love me? Why was he always so upset with me? All I wanted was a life like other girls. Maybe I did something wrong. Maybe I wasn't good enough. That's why he was always so angry. I just wanted us to be a family. I just wanted him to love me. Why couldn't we just be happy?
I don't know, Alice.
You'll never leave me, right? Promise you'll never go. Together forever.
Forever.
Thank you. 700 android. I was designed to serve you. What can I do for you?
My program has detected an anomaly. Please contact the nearest CyberLife Maintenance Center.
Hello, Amanda.
Connor, it's good to see you. Your predecessor was unfortunately destroyed. It knew deviants could be unpredictable, but it wasn't careful enough. I hope you won't make the same mistake.
I don't intend to.
When a Connor model is destroyed, its memory is transferred to the next one. But some data can be lost in the process. Avoid being destroyed. It would be better for you and the investigation.
I understand.
The interrogation seemed challenging. What did you think of the deviant?
It showed signs of PTSD after being abused by its owner. As if its original program had been completely replaced by new instructions.
This Lieutenant Anderson has been officially assigned to the deviancy case. What do you make of him?
I think he's irritable and socially challenged. But I also think he used to be a good detective. He's an intriguing character.
Unfortunately, we have no choice but to work with him. What do you think is the best approach?
I will adapt to his personality. It is in the best interest of the investigation that I avoid conflict and try to accommodate his psychology.
More and more androids show signs of deviancy. There are millions in circulation. If they become unstable, the consequences will be disastrous. You're the most advanced prototype CyberLife has ever created. If anyone can figure out what's happening, it's you.
You can count on me, Amanda.
Pick up the investigation where the previous Connor left off and put a stop to this. Hurry, Connor. There's little time.
Can I help you?
I'm here to see Lieutenant Anderson.
Do you have authorization?
Yes.
Lieutenant Anderson hasn't arrived yet, but you can wait at his desk. You might be in shock.
Tensions in the Arctic have reached a new level. A Russian carrier and an American patrol group.
Hey, you take a look at these samples yet?
Lab report says they cut it with something.
The Minister for Defense, Dennis Riggs,
maybe they're trying out a new form of red ice.
That cannot go unanswered. The countries in the region, particularly Sweden...
I'm looking for Lieutenant Anderson's desk.
Forces to withdraw.
It's that desk right there.
So far, there has been no response from either Moscow or Washington. We'll keep you informed minute by minute.
You and you come with me.
Excuse me. Do you know what time Lieutenant Anderson usually arrives?
Depends on where he was the night before. If we're lucky, we'll see him before noon.
Thanks. Call Hank Anderson.
Hi, this is Hank. Not here at the moment. You can leave a message if that's what turns you on, but don't expect me to call back. Beep. Whatever.
Hello, Lieutenant. My name is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife.
God, I saw you get shot in the head last night.
My predecessor was unfortunately destroyed. but CyberLife transferred its memory and sent me to replace it. This incident should not affect the investigation.
Oh, Jesus. Hank! In my office! I've got 10 new cases involving androids on my desk every day. We've always had isolated incidents. Old ladies losing their android maids and that kind of crap. But now, we're getting reports of assaults and even homicide, like that guy last night. This isn't just CyberLife's problem anymore. It's now a criminal investigation, and we've got to deal with it before the shit hits the fan. I want you to investigate these cases and see if there's any link.
Why me? Why do I gotta be the one to deal with this shit? I am the least qualified cop in the country to handle this case. I know jack shit about androids, Jeffrey. I can barely change the settings on my own phone.
Everybody's overloaded. I think you're perfectly qualified for this type of investigation.
Bullshit! The truth is, nobody wants to investigate these fucking androids, and you let me hold the bag.
CyberLife sent over this android to help with the investigation. It's a state-of-the-art prototype. It'll act as your partner.
No fucking way! I don't need a partner, and certainly not this plastic prick!
Hank, you are seriously starting to piss me off! You are a police lieutenant! You are supposed to do what I say, and shut your goddamn mouth!
You know what my goddamn mouth has to say to you?
Okay.
Huh?
Okay. I'll pretend like I didn't hear that, so I don't have to add any more pages to your disciplinary folder, cause it already looks like a fucking novel! This conversation is over!
Jeffrey, Jesus Christ, why are you doing this to me? You know how much I hate these fucking things. Why are you doing this to me?
Listen, I've had just about enough of your bitching. Either you do your job or you hand in your badge. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got work to do. Ugh.
I would like to start reviewing the case files. Can you tell me where I can...
Talk to Hank. Close the door on your way out.
Have a nice day, Captain.